We have some very interesting conversations around the area of people. Ultimately, people is what make the organization. And today with me is a very interesting guest who is from the world of financial services, from the HR and from insurance. Hello, Ruchira.
Hello.
Insurance industry as such has always been facing the issue of attrition in a big way. How do you think the organizations are coping up with this? And how do you think that the kind of motivation levels are kept up amongst the people to make sure that this attrition ratio issues are controlled and you have to maintain a stable scale of business?
It is a challenge in the insurance sector, especially in life, where you are wanting to attract the brightest of the people to join you because it's one of the most complicated financial product that is available. So you would want the right set of people with the right set of perseverance level, the right set of empathy, the right set of skills to build relationship with the customers and clients. So it is a mix of a lot of softer issues with people and also hardcore selling skills, right, to oppose that. So it is a difficult combination. Plus, it is not a pull product, as in everybody doesn't wake up in the morning and says, oh, today I'm going to get a life insurance policy. So the softer issues are what is required in terms of building that relationship with the clients and the customers. And that needs a lot of perseverance. Over the years, I've seen mostly, and I will talk about what we have been doing in future generally, we were focusing on the retention part. So once we have onboarded a person who's a talent for us, how do we retain? So there is, of course, entire ecosystem which works. So the manager, the hiring manager, the skip level manager, HR, the training people, the operations people, everybody comes together to see that the person becomes successful. The second thing we started doing recently is took a step back and we said, who are the kind of people we should get onboarded? And we realized that algorithm and data has a huge say in selecting the right kind of person to join our company. We went back and analyzed past 2.5 years data, and we analyzed almost 30 attributes of the people who have come and joined us, people who have then also become successful, or people who have stayed for a certain period of time and then have quit to go on to do something else. And we realized there is a persona of people who can become successful. And you will be surprised, there are all such kinds of people who have become successful. There are young graduates who have become successful. There are, of course, people who have been in the insurance sector with certain degree of stability have become successful. There are women who have become successful. So we know there are 4 or 5 personas who are there in the industry who can do a good join the organization and can successfully go on to get promotions, build their career in the insurance sector.
In fact, this interdepartmental training, especially when the sales guy always, there is definitely a rift between the sales and the compliance guys and the underwriters. Typically in most of the insurance organization, because the sales guy wants to get in the maximum business and those policies get rejected, and that causes a lot of tensions in between the teams at many a time. Have you also been observing such kind of things?
We are in my company, actually, we are in a very unique situation. As I mentioned, we believe that the entire ecosystem has to come together to collaborate to see that everybody is successful.
Correct.
So, in fact, I must also share a very, very, very interesting thing. When we do our goal setting at the highest level, the CEO and all his rundowns, so all the CXOs, we do a joint goal setting for each one of us.
Okay.
So for example, if I say that recruitment is one of my deliverables, and if I give only 10% weightage to that deliverable, my head of agency might say that, Ruchira, you need to have more focus on getting the right set of people, and hence 10% weightage for this goal is not good enough. So should you increase? So it flows down right from the top to see how everybody is having shared responsibility on making the organization and end of the day that the strategy or the objective for the year is met.
So it is more of a wholesome program. Interesting insights. Thank you very much, Ruchira. Wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.